Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, now we have did earlier that is what is Avogadro law. Based on that we have did a theory, and now we are going to solve a numerical based on Avogadro's law. So let us do that. So friends, this is a numerical which is based on Avogadro's law that is presented on a screen. And what does it say? Let us see. It says that a balloon is being filled with 8.65 into 10 raised to 22 molecules of hydrogen at the given pressure and temperature. So the thing is, the volume of the balloon was 3.2 dm³ at that time. So if 0.2 moles of more hydrogen is being added in the balloon, then find the volume if pressure and temperature are kept constant. So in this case, what we should concern is that in both the cases, the same gas, that is the hydrogen gas, is being used, but the condition is different. Initially they have represented the number of particles it was, or number of molecules it was, basically 8.65 into 10 raised to 22 molecules, while that of which had a volume of 3.2 dm³. and in next condition, what they are saying that they have introduced 0.2 moles of more hydrogen, and from that thing we have to calculate that what would be the new volume it would create if we will add 0.2 moles of hydrogen in that. So we have to find the volume of the next one if pressure and constant are pressure and temperature are being kept constant. So the first thing that we could do is we could extract the data from the given question. So let us do the extraction of data from the given question. So the given data says that the initial volume, that is the starting volume that they have given to us, or they have provided to us, which was basically, I would say it as V1, which was given as 3.2 dm³, while that of the number of moles of which was been given to us, actually they have not represented the number of moles, they have given the number of particles of the gas, of hydrogen gas. So I would write it as N, that is capital N for the number of particles of gas of hydrogen, number of molecules of hydrogen, so what they have given is, they have given 8.65 into 10 raised to 22 molecules of hydrogen gas. And now what I am going to do is, I am going to convert, I could convert this into number of moles, because as if in Avogadro law we know that the volume will increase if the number of moles or the number of particles of the gas will increase. So in this case what I am going to do is, I am going to convert this number of moles of hydrogen into the this number of molecules of hydrogen into number of moles of hydrogen that would be present if this much particle is being present, or it has been given to us. So as we know that for 1 mole of hydrogen, of hydrogen gas, if I would say, it will occupy a volume of 22.4 dm³, but that 22.4 dm³, or that is 1 mole of hydrogen gas, will consist of 6.022 into 10 raised to 23 molecules of the hydrogen gas. So in this case, what I could do is, as they have mentioned us the particles, number of particles, so what I am going to do is, so therefore the 8.65 into 10 raised to 22 molecules of H2 gas will occupy, suppose, X moles of H2 gas. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to cross multiply, and we have to calculate that what would be the initial number of moles when 8.65 into 10 raised to 22 particles of hydrogen is being present to us. So this is the thing that I'm going to calculate. So let us do it. So therefore, the X, I have made a cross multiplication in this thing, so I could get it as 8.65 into 10 raised to 22 multiplied by 1 divided by, that is 6.022 into 10 raised to 23, and let us see what is the number of mole of hydrogen gas that we could get. So basically we have got 0.143 as the moles of hydrogen which is present in, that is in which 8.65 into 10 raised to 22 particles or molecules of gas, of H2 gas has been present. So in this case, what we have got is, we have initially we have got V1 as 3.2 dm cube, while that of the number of moles that we have calculated now, that is this one itself, that is the N1, is suppose 0.143. And in this case, what they have asked is, they have asked that what would be the final volume. That means they have asked that what would be the V2 if 0.2 moles of more hydrogen is been added in it. So suppose the initial volume that they have given, the number of moles that we have calculated, it was 0.143. But in that 0.143 moles of hydrogen, they have added, that is 0.2 moles of hydrogen more. So therefore, the number of moles have been increased. That is, the total number of moles has been increased from, that is, it will be 0.2 plus initially that was present, that is 0.143. So if I calculate this thing, so what I have got is, I have got 0.34. So therefore, this is 0.343. So this is the number of moles for both the conditions, that is when 3.2 dm cube is being present, that means it has 0.143 moles of hydrogen, and we have to calculate what would be the number of what would be the value or volume of the gas if 0.343 moles of hydrogen gas has been present. But as we know, that is according to Avogadro's law, that is V1 divided by N1 is equals to V2 divided by N2. And in this case, the value of V1 is given, that is we have calculated as 3.2, by that of N1, which was found to be 0.143, which is equals to, that is V2, which is what we have to calculate, and the value of N2 that we have did is after addition of 0.2 moles of the hydrogen gas in 0.143 moles of hydrogen gas. So it had made a sum of 0.343. So therefore, what I'll going to do is, I'll go to cross multiply this thing and let us see what is the answer that we could get. So therefore, 3.2 multiplied by 0.343, which makes 2 divided with the 0.143. So let us see what is the answer. So the answer that we have got is 7.67 dm cube. So this is what we have got the answer. So let us compare the thing, and we could analyze that whether we are following the Avogadro rule or not. So for that instance, I explained it earlier also, as I do this kind of explanation, where the initial volume, which was 3.2 dm cube, and the number of moles which was found to be, it was 0.143, and now when the number of moles has been increased, that is 0.343, then I could find that the volume that I have got, it was 7.67 dm cube. So this indicates that suppose if volume V1 is been 3.2 and it has a particular number of moles, that is 0.143, and if I increase the number of moles, that is from 0.143 to 0.343. So as the number of moles of the gas will increase, that the volume will also increase. Initially it was 3.2, now it is 7.67. This indicates that this is following Avogadro's law, and yes, as the number of moles increases, the volume also increases. So thank you friends for watching the video. I hope you have liked this video, and yes, you will share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.